Hey, what's up everyone? My name is Chapito, it's the Ocho, and today I'm going to show you guys another way how to install the Homebrew channel on your Nintendo Wii. Now, if you guys don't know what I'm talking about, I recently uploaded a video on how to install the Homebrew channel with the letterbot method. But today I'm going to show you guys another way how you can download the Homebrew channel without using an SD card. And that's by using the start the hex method. But first, if you guys want to see more videos like this in the future, be sure to like this video, subscribe, and be sure to turn on all notifications. And now without any further ado, let's begin! So, what exactly is the start the hex method? The start the hex method is another way of installing the Homebrew channel. And how this works, this can be triggered by loading the Wii End User License Agreement. All you need for this tutorial is a Nintendo Wii console with an internet connection. You're also going to need to change the DNS settings on your Wii, and you want to make sure your Wii System Menu version is updated to 4.3. So if you guys don't know how to connect your Wii to the internet, then look back in my previous video as I demonstrated how to set up your Wii to the internet and how to update your Wii. And before we begin, there's two things I want to point out. One, this video only works for unmodded Wii, so if you already have Homebrew installed on your Wii, don't do this, and I'll be sure to make a video on how to safely uninstall all Homebrew content. And one last thing I should mention, the Wii Mini does not support any online functionality or compatibility, so this procedure won't work on the Wii Mini. This can be allowed only the original 2006 model or the Family Edition, not the Wii Mini. And I also want to give out a safety warning plus a copyright warning for this video. Warning, I do not condone and do not support piracy. I also do not approve of sharing misleading or insensitive information to the public without proper consent or permission. If anything bad happens to your electronic device, please understand I am not responsible for any damages, so do not try doing this unless you know exactly what you're doing. This video is made for educational purposes only, and if you guys have any questions regarding to this video, please be sure to leave them in the comment section below. Thank you! First, power on your Wii, and then you want to head down to Wii Options. Then go to Wii Settings. Scroll to page 2 and click on Internet. Then click on Connection Settings. You should have a current internet connection set up, but if you don't, then create one. And once you do have your internet connection set up, click on your current connection and then go to change settings. From here, we want to change our DNS settings. So scroll to the next page until you get to auto obtain DNS. By default, it should say yes, but we're going to choose no. So click no and then go to advanced settings. From here, we want to type in this specific code as our primary and secondary DNS, 18.188.135.9. This is the code for launching the exploit. Now, before we hit confirm, there's actually one thing I want to point out about the DNS code. If this code here does not work for you, then try inputting this code instead. 97.74.103.14 as your primary. And for the secondary, 173.201.71.14. Try that one and see if it works. That if not, then check back with your router settings and make sure custom DNS settings is enabled. But if your router is not compatible with any custom changes at all, then it's not compatible for your setup. So once you're finished, select confirm and press save. Select OK to perform a connection test. You should be able to connect to the internet just like that with absolutely no problems at all. But again, if your router or your internet service provider does not allow you to use any custom DNS settings, then this procedure won't work. So you will have to try the letterbomb method instead. But my ISP should be able to work just fine, so results may vary. If the connection test is successful, then it will ask you to update your Wii. So if your Wii hasn't been updated yet, go ahead and update. But if it's already at the final version, then select no. My Wii is already at the final version, so we're going to choose no. So go back to the internet section. And then from here, we want to go to user's agreements. It'll ask you to launch the user agreements. Hit yes. And then the screen will say, you must review the user agreements before using Wii Network services. Hit next, continue, and wait for a few seconds. If you see a My Little Pony character, aka Rainbow Dash, on the screen, then you set it up correctly. If not, you must have done something wrong. If you've done something wrong, let me know down in the comment section below. Now wait for at least 1 to 2 minutes for this trigger to download the payload. And once it does, you'll be able to go through the Hackwii installer so you continue. And also, you want to make sure your Wii remote stays active for this, so if your battery dies, power off your Wii completely, charge them, and then try again. If for some reason the Hackwii installer doesn't load and instead freezes, or it comes to a point where you can't take about 1 to 2 minutes to load the payload, restart your Wii, reconnect to the internet, and keep trying again. And also, if you have a mod like Mario Kart TTTP or Project M, then power off your Wii, remove your SD card, power back on, and try again. If I'm just keeping it real with you guys, I honestly don't know why it sometimes freezes just like that. I honestly had to redo this procedure like 3 times. I mean, I don't know a way around this, but if this procedure does not work for you, then letterbomb is a total different option. You could get an SD card for just only $20, and I have an instruction video on how to do that. The link will be in the description below. Alright, so if you guys see this line of code, that means it's downloading the Hackwii installer. And if you see this message that says SD card not found, don't worry about that. That means if you're trying to install BootMe on your SD card, it'll ask you to use your SD card. But you won't need an SD card for this, I promise you. But you will be able to use an SD card for installing BootMe. I'll make a video on how to do that in the future. Alright, we're almost there. And of course, there's a scam warning, and this one should be 100% for free to download. I promise you, you won't have to pay for it, but if you end up paying for it, then yes, you will have to get your money back ASAP. So wait for the bottom text to say, press 1 to continue, and then you should be into the Hackwii installer. Okay guys, since we're here at the Hackwii installer, we can now be able to install the homebrew channel. Alright, so I'm gonna click on install the homebrew channel. And then press continue, and then give it a few seconds. Once it's done installing the homebrew channel, press continue, then select exit, and then you'll be taken to the homebrew channel. Congratulations! You have successfully installed the homebrew channel. And as I mentioned before, there'll be nothing there. That's because we haven't downloaded any homebrew apps. You can go to the OpenShop channel to download any homebrew channel app you want. The link will be in the description below. And that's gonna do it for today's video. So thank you guys so much for watching. And as I said before, if this procedure doesn't work for you guys, then try using Letterbomb and see if you can get the homebrew channel off from there. But anyways, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll be sure to make a video on how to get Boot Me on your Wii, and I'll also show you how to download Freeloader, which is an extra layer of protection for your Wii, and I'll show you where you can download it. So thank you guys so much, and I'll see you guys again next time. Peace out. We'll be right back.